In this topic, we'll be covering more sophisticated ARM templates. So Kale, can you tell us a little bit about what a more sophisticated ARM template may cover and what you can do with them?
Sure. Yeah, I get this question all the time because when we're working with customers, this ARM model is kind of new to them, right? So this is something new that we've created, and I wanted to kind of draw out really quickly to give you a sense for why it's important around advanced topics such as like looping or naming of these resources whenever we're doing it, linking templates, all these types of advanced things that we would do with ARM templates, how it kind of works. So from a high level, if we took a look at a little diagram here, we could say when we're in classic mode, let's start there real quick, and I'll just give you a little blast from the past here. So right here was our API for Azure, right? And we used to call this ASM. We do now. It's a service management API. So a client, somebody would call into this thing and say, I want to create a VM. I need a VM. The API would then say, okay, I need to go do these things based on some parameters that he passed me, right? So he'd pass a bunch of parameters over and say, go create this VM. And the API here would then say, okay, I'm going to go off and do that. And then eventually out the other side would pop a VM or an app service or something. So this is basic model for like ASM. The issue was that this guy was kind of like a bottleneck, right? The API, because the way it was architected really wasn't architected to be like programmatic kind of thing. So basically you had to come through this API, which was a REST API, which was really nice, but had some limiting factors to it. So what we did then is said, we still have an API with ARM, which is Azure Resource Manager. And so we'll just call this ARM. And what this does is we could still make calls into the API and do these kind of one-off things. Like if we wanted to create a VM, we could still do that. But we can also bring in a template, right? And so this template is just JSON. And so the interesting thing there is like, yeah, it's great. We can kind of script out our infrastructure. And this is what's going to describe how we build whatever we're going to build inside Azure. We'll take a VM, for instance, because that's the easiest case. But then you start to think, what more could I do with that, right? So sometimes you want to do things dynamically, right? You don't want to just say, I want to create one VM. I want to create 15 VMs, all based on this one image. Well, then it started to get a little bit more complex. And so some of these topics, let me just show you some of the things we've been working on or some of the more advanced ones. If you pop over to the portal, and there's actually a new thing here that's kind of interesting. It's called templates. So if you don't see this, if you hit this little browse button here in the portal and actually scroll down to the bottom, they're alphabetical, you'll see this templates that's in preview. If you come into here, you can actually store your own templates. And so in this case, I created one for a hackathon. And what this allows you to do, you can actually see, I put a description in here, allows you to spin up many instances with a custom image. And so in this case, if we just took a look at this, from a basic sense, you should already know kind of what an ARM template is, JSON, and this describes kind of the schema of some of the input variables and the parameters that we're going to use. But when you start to say, okay, I want to create multiple, and I'll show you what this looks like in the portal in a second, but let me show you just this one section right here. So let me just go ahead and zoom in on that. So if you look at like this section right here, this is the public IPs. So we're going to create some public IP addresses, you can see here, and specifically, we're going to be creating, we use this copy variable, which is basically going to create this variable for us called the public IP loop, and it's going to read this parameter that I pass in called total nodes. So in my case, I'm going to ask the user, how many nodes do you want to spin up? Let's say they say 10. When this thing loops through, it's going to do this 10 times. Then what happens is, we're actually going to use it right below it here. So in this case, right here is my resource. And I'm going to go ahead and prefix it with a core name prefix. Again, that's a parameter I asked them for. So they could say VM1, VM2 in a very simple case. In my case, we actually usually use a unique name, like your name or the name of the hackathon or something like that. But then you can see that we're doing this concat function. So there is some functions inside ARM that you can use. So we're going to concatenate whatever the core name is with this pip, which is just a static thing that we're going to add there. And then we'll do copy index, which is basically going to go ahead and grab the next iteration of whatever's output by this. So in that case, we're doing a loop of just a number. So like 1 through 10, or whatever the person had entered as the upper variable. And to show you what this looks like kind of in action, when you do a deploy here, you can see, here's our parameters. So our template we just showed you, but here's our parameters. And you can see total nodes. And I say the total number of VMs to create, and that's where you would add like 10. And that's going to go ahead and append it. Here's your core name prefix. So you could say something like whatever your name is, VM. And then it would basically create VM 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10. And every one of the pieces that needs to be unique, like the public IP address I just showed you, storage accounts, all these different things, will also get that appended. So that's one kind of, when you're doing looping logic, how you can kind of loop through and use like a variable that you create kind of on the fly. The other stuff that's interesting, and I'm popping over here, if you guys are interested in ARM, you should take a look out here at this GitHub site. Let me go ahead and zoom in so you guys can see where this is. But if you go to GitHub and just go to Quick Start Templates, when you go there, there's a ton of them that are out there. And some of the more advanced ones I'll show you here. So this one happens to be Cloudera on CentOS, which is a Linux operating system. But in this case, I wanted to show you that they're basically doing some redirects to other templates. So you can see right here in this module. So we have our resources defined, just like every ARM template. Inside of here, we're going to be doing some deployments, but you can see that we have this template link, and we have a URI going to a variable called shared resources URI. So in this case, we actually have a variable, and I can show you it's instantiated above here, which actually points to one of the other scripts that are in this. So if we rolled up to the variables, you could see it's right here, this guy. And so you can see he's going to go ahead and concatenate a script, another one, which is right above it, which happens to be in GitHub. So that's pointing out to an external link slash shared resources slash whatever else we passed into there. In this case, there's stuff for VNets. You can see this one's actually doing a CentOS. And if you look out, let me just scroll up here. What you basically do is drop those out here. So Azure Deploy is our main script. But you can see it was calling setup Cloudera JSON. That's another ARM template. So in that way, you can kind of nest logic, and that's kind of like a best practice when you're building really sophisticated ARM templates. It's not to try to put everything in one template, because you're going to have this template that's like 1,000 lines long, and debugging it and trying to fix things is going to be very difficult. So in that case, you probably want to basically compartmentalize or modularize what you're doing in ARM into different scripts, and then go ahead and plug those together, again, kind of like Legos, so that you can make this output that you're actually looking for. And then you can reuse it too. So some of the stuff that you might use in one template, you could use in another. So that kind of, when you're getting started with this stuff, it's great to go out and look at the Quick Start templates for ideas, because that's where you see a lot of these different things that are being instantiated by more like very sophisticated type ARM templates. Great place to start, and then kind of riff on those and build whatever you need to perform what functions you're looking for. And so that kind of wraps our module here on some of the advanced topics around ARM templates.